Well, there are almost 17,000 active cases of COVID-19 right now in Australia. Hospitals nearing capacity, ICU beds counting more and more patients each and every day.
Early intervention can help prevent serious illness. Here is what you should do if you or someone you know gets the virus.
Step one, get a test. Symptoms can be mild, so if you suspect an infection, head straight to your nearest testing centre. And that doesn't mean ducking past the shops.
Once you've made that decision that you're going to get tested, you have to assume that potentially you are positive, you are at risk to the community. You go and get tested, and then you go home from that point. You do not pass go, and you don't go anywhere else until you've got that result.
If your test returns positive, telling your GP is a smart move. They can help you monitor for symptoms and keep an eye on those around you. Young, fit and healthy 25-year-old Ari Paris thought she couldn't catch COVID.
I was just getting sicker and sicker, unexplainably sicker. The headaches were the worst part, and then I found out when I had really bad chest pain. My mum thought it was an ear infection, and I went to hospital, and then I got a call saying I had COVID.
Ari spent the next 2 weeks in her bedroom in isolation. Her mum looked after her food and medications.
My GP called me every couple of days to check in on me, which was really helpful. But I think the main other service that I found helpful and sought was my friend who had had COVID, and just the support of knowing someone who had been through it, because it is so scary.
Ari's experience is not uncommon. Last month, Dr. Hannah El-Khoury looked after more than 100 COVID patients. And by knowing their result, he also helped the health department connect mystery cases.
That's where the issue can be solved, by communicating most of this information with the GP, because they know the dynamic and the structure of the family around, especially when you're talking about extended family from ethnic background.
If symptoms worsen, organise a telehealth appointment. Your GP will decide if you need more serious attention. New modelling suggests 11% of COVID-positive people will need hospital care.
The rate of respirations, the depth of respirations, how many words you can get out per breath will help us even remotely understand how acute those shortness of breath symptoms are.
Early intervention can prevent serious illness. Health officials are worried about the number of COVID-positive patients presenting to hospital without being previously diagnosed.
People saying, oh, I had a COVID test 2 weeks ago, I've got a tickle in the throat, it can't be COVID. Understanding that symptoms continually change and evolve, and a negative test, even near 10 days ago, 7 days ago, does not exclude the possibility of COVID now.
It's also important to declare any respiratory issues before you turn up to a clinic.
The clinic will often have a separate entrance, or indeed a relationship with the local respiratory clinic, the GP respiratory clinic, for attending to patients with potentially COVID symptoms to minimise the risk to others.
Northern Hospital in Melbourne has a virtual ED triage to help patients remotely. Acting COO Deborah Byrne says the number of people in COVID care and ICU is increasing every day.
I won't sugarcoat it. It is hard going for these nurses, medical staff.
Current data shows approximately a fifth of hospitalisations need intensive care. For Ari, it was an experience that weighed heavy on her mental health.
You can be young, fit and healthy, but as soon as you get it and you go to hospital, all they can tell you is statistically you'll be fine, which isn't very comforting when you can't breathe.
Those who work tirelessly in the ICU say there's one way to avoid it, and that's getting the vaccine.
A lot of people talk about waiting, you know, I just want to wait and see. I want to wait and see whether I'll get the vaccination. I think a lot of the staff here and a lot of the clinicians would ask, what are you waiting for? Are you waiting to come into our ICU? Are you waiting to come into the COVID ward? You need to get the vaccination now, which protect yourself, protect your loved ones, and protect the community.